Welcome back to the County Connection Show for June. Again, I'm Scott. This is Thomas, Dan, and Karn, your county commissioners. Thanks very much for joining us. We are going to talk a bunch about some different transportation initiatives or alternative transportation initiatives. We're going to start off with what is called Bustang.
Bustang is Colorado's first ever state-owned and operated bus system, connecting major populations, employment centers, and local transit entities while easing congestion along the I-25 and I-70 corridors. Coloradans have a thirst for adventure that takes us all over our state, from the Front Range to the Rockies. Bustang is proud to reflect this wandering spirit. Check it out! That's Colorado's reflection in Bustang's windows. So the next time you're thinking of commuting through our great state, consider upgrading your ride to Bustang.
And who wants to start with Bustang?
I can maybe give the history, and then everyone can kind of chime in a little bit. But it's the first ever effort by Colorado Department of Transportation to have a transportation bus system that they fully managed. You know, there's RTD down, that's a special district on the Front Range. We of course have Summit Stage up here in Summit County and Free Ride for Breck and so forth. But Bustang is Colorado Department of Transportation's version of our Summit Stage. And so it was created out of a bill back in 2009. There was a carve out of a bill called FASTER that created about $15 million to help fund transit rail.
Who carried
that bill? Some young punk kid.
It was my bill. But anyways, it was a way to say CDOT shouldn't just be like a division of highways, but we need to look to the future to look at multimodal transportation systems in Colorado. So I'm really excited to see this start, and it'll be a bus service that will go from Glenwood Springs more or less down to Denver's Union Station, and back you guys jump in with the rest. Mm-hmm. And
well,
back
we
up.
Got to go on an inaugural ride, mm-hmm. and it is a super cool and cushy bus. Very smooth ride, very comfy seats. You can plug in your devices and charge them while you're riding. You have Wi-Fi. We went through the section of Eagle County where there is no cell service and there was Wi-Fi. So it's just a really cool ride and very convenient going from transit center to transit center. So Glenwood, Eagle, Vail, our Frisco Transfer Center, and straight on down to Union Station.
And it's affordable, right?
$12 from Frisco Transfer Station to Union Station.
Right
now, there's just one ride a day, and it goes in this western section. There's also Fort Collins to Denver and Colorado Springs to Denver, Bustang. But ours, they just have once a day. So get out and ride it. If we have good ridership, we'll get more buses.
Yeah. In the time frame right now, Monday through Friday, picks you up Frisco Transfer Center at 8:55, and then Union Station at the end of the day, it
six
picks you
o'clock.
Up at 6 or 6:15, somewhere around there. So it's perfect if folks want to go down there to check out a baseball game or shopping or work-related,
the redevelopment of Union Station is just fabulous. If you haven't seen it yet, that's worth going to see, and it would be really worth going to see it on the Bustang.
So July 13th.
There's no parking fee then, because you're dropped off. If you were to do that same trip, you'd be paying a lot for parking, let alone the gas and wear and tear on your car. It's a bargain.
Some people have been a little concerned that it's not offered on the weekend because you know, we're the I-70 Coalition. We are working really hard to figure out ways to get vehicles off, you know, to use alternative routes and use buses and so forth. But this will be strictly during the week, and it's geared towards kind of working folks that are heading down there. And if it is popular, hopefully it will be, and they'll look to expand on weekends.
Okay.
And they'll also be offering this on kind of north end up towards Fort Collins, so your daughter can potentially use it to head back here, actually. That's a good idea. And then there'll be a southern route as well, heading down to Colorado Springs. So it won't be just the I-70 Mountain Corridor, but other major corridors in the state as well.
Okay. And real quick, there's a seniors, an event, a preview event of Bustang at the Community and Senior Center in Frisco on the 23rd of June. at 3:30 p.m. and that's for seniors and those folks with disabilities and the opportunities or the options that this service may provide to those folks. And so certainly you're welcome to check that out as well.
And there is a 25% discount off of that low fare for people with disabilities and seniors.
Great, great. All right, so from buses to bikes. So Thomas, you want to talk a little bit about the Summit Cove Loop and bike lane project?
Yeah, so we had another open house just last week or the week before in Summit Cove. We're working on putting bike lanes in along the main roadways through the Summit Cove area. That went really well, even on a sunny afternoon. We actually had people come and take a look at the first phase of this, which is on Summit Drive. That work starts here soon, and we'll do this first phase this summer. And then there are two more phases after that. So here in the next 3 years, our plan is to get the whole loop, main loop through Summit Cove renovated so that we've got bike lanes attached to either side of the road. And yeah, it's an exciting project.
Mm-hmm.
And so along with that, we'll be doing significant repaving of some of the different circles that are there in Summit Cove as well. So we're really looking forward to that. And thanks again to everybody that turned out. And just be patient this summer with the construction mm-hmm. as we work on all of this. But there's a great payoff after we get that done. So,
well, our season is so short, so whether it's right. you know, Summit Cove or Highway 9 or I-70, I mean, there's going to be a lot going on, but yeah please have patience for sure.
Yep. And certainly think that this will the end result will be a safer way for kids to get to and from school there in Summit Cove as well, so in addition to the recreation.
So sticking with bikes, there's a Bike to Work Day event that's coming up as well. Dan, do you want to talk a little bit about that one?
Yeah, next Wednesday, I believe, Bike to Work. It's part of our Open Space and Trails Department organizes. Mm-hmm. I believe Katie Kent is the lead on that. We have that mm-hmm. annually. I believe it's part of a national Bike to Work effort too. And we'll be offering refreshments and so forth. I don't know all the locations. Definitely,
yeah. So
in the past, we've been at the County Commons.
It says that so it includes FERC, Pants, Summit County, mm-hmm. Dillon, Silverthorne, Frisco, and Breck are all partnering together. Mm-hmm. Six breakfast stations throughout Summit County. So I'll read what those are: the Island Grill in Frisco after work as well for Bike to Work Day happy hour, and then there are. Snacks and raffle prizes and giveaways and so forth. So again, for the details about the event, just go to the county's website yeah. and to the open space page, and you should be able to find the detailed information about Bike to Work Day. But certainly we
check
hope that
out.
People
yeah.
check that out.
Definitely.
All right, our last transportation topic that we want to talk about is RAMP, which I'm not going to remember what that stands for, and the Highway 9 North project. So Karn, I'll let you talk about that one.
Responsible acceleration of maintenance and partnerships. So Highway 9 North is undergoing massive reconstruction right now, and this is just an amazing project. They're working on about 6 miles of it now. It goes from County Road 30, the Green Mountain Dam Road, to almost Kremling. And that stretch of highway is the most dangerous stretch of highway in Colorado for wildlife collisions. So the really exciting part of that project is there are 7 wildlife crossings in the project, 2 overpasses and 5 underpasses. So they're doing half of it this summer and half of it next summer. And so if you're frustrated going toward Steamboat or toward the Colorado River from here, be sure you get on to the website or email that Brad's going to stream here so that you can see it. Just know that in a couple years, it's going to be a spectacular piece of highway, one of a kind in the United States. Mm-hmm. And we have to be patient with the construction as it's continuing this summer and next summer.
But yeah, definitely a giant project and great to see that one underway.
Yeah.
All right, we're going to take another quick break, and then we'll be back with a couple more subjects.